Hey boys, hey girls, let's make us a Sauerbraten. I love Sauerbraten, and Miss JB don't. Shame on them, and both of me. So what we got to do is I got some Sauerbraten mix from Germany, from a friend of mine, Joe Hill, in Germany. He sent me this. Put a good tablespoon of that pickling spice in there, and it's just an extra little dose. Now, we need to, preferably a nice German red sweet wine would be good in this, a white sweet wine, but I don't have none. I got some dry Cabernet Sauvignon. How much should I put? Look, all the little measuring increments have worn off this sucker. So I put that much. I think this was a 4-cup measuring device. So to sweeten it up, oh, this son of a bitch is stuck. Let me get a gripper. I had to curse at it. So I got some balsamic vinegar. It's a sweet vinegar, and this one is Calavita brand from Modena, Italy, and that's going to sweeten up our wine. Not to mention we got to have vinegars in here too. I also got just some plain white vinegar, and we're going to put some of that in there. How much? Watch it pour. The recipe really called for a red wine vinegar, but we just fixed it. So we're gonna go ahead and bring this to a boil in the nuke, let it cool, and go from there. It's the way you cool something down quick. This is the way they do it in restaurants. Get you some cold water, put you some ice cubes in it, and that's the hot vinegar pickling spice thing that we just brought up to a simmer in the nuke and let it cool off. You can do it quick like this, or you can just leave it sitting in the refrigerator for an hour or so. This is fast. It's called a water bath. Shit. Alcohol abuse. Spilled some beer. Damn it. When I choked up. Rump roast up there out the fridge. It was on sale for $2.99 a pound, something like that. So, open your rump roasts, rinse your mouth in the zinc. Maybe you should have already opened this bag, but we do it with our damn teeth. One hand had rump roast. Both of them had rump roast. Let me wrench them off. I grabbed the bag with my teeth and opened the damn thing. I forgot to open it prior to. So, look, down here. Come on. This tripod got a few issues. And I see low back flashing. Let's go on and get us some garlics in here. I like garlic, that's all to it. And let's pour this in there. And drag all that them pickling spices in there too. Put us a sacrificial onion in there, all slice up, or just rough cut is all it is. Then we're gonna marinate this in the refrigerator for 55 days. You can go anywhere from 3 to 5 days with this in the fridge. The longer, the better. So we're gonna do that. And this is cooled down all the way, like to 40 degrees, sitting in an ice bath. I hope you was recording, stupid. Yeah, you were, good. So, fill your compartment in your sink with some water, and let that water help burp the air out the bag. I got it cracked open right there on that side, all this side seal up. And look, all the air coming right out of that bag. Now seal that little part up. And you got almost all the air out. Okay. So now your marinade can do its job and do it well. Almost like vacuum sealing, huh? Do make sure your sink is clean so you don't contaminate your refrigerator with nasty shit that may have been in there. And we go from here in a week. What did I make last night? I made jambalaya. No video, sorry. I could watch one of my older videos. I know, back off from the camera. What am I making tonight? You're gonna see it before this video airs. The Sauerbraten video airs. It's carnitas. And they were some good by the time you see this video. All right, boys and girls, let's continue on that Sauerbraten as soon as I find my pop. It's been marinating in the refrigerator for 5 days, and it ought to really be good. Last time I done one for 3 days, and it was pretty good. So this one ought to kick butt. First, I seen a little article the other day. Do you need to preheat your oil before you fry something? It depends on what you're doing. For meats, fish, things like that, it can prevent the food from sticking. Raw proteins interact with metal on the actual molecular level. It doesn't just stick by getting stuck in the pores and microscopic cracks, even though some people think that. Even on a very smooth and polished surface with no cracks or imperfections, meat can still stick as proteins form molecular bonds with the metal. Up here, boy. Pay attention up here. Don't fall down no more. I see you auto-panning on me. So, how does preheating prevent this? The thing is, only the raw proteins will form this bond. Heat causes the proteins to fold in on themselves, okay? Or even break down and form new compounds. Once in their folded and rearranged form, they will no longer stick. Now, things you wouldn't want to preheat oil for would be sweating some onions down. If you get your oil too hot, in other words, you can preheat it a little bit. So would you want to preheat a pan with nothing in it? No, because you can't tell how hot it is unless you got one of my nuclear thermal laser pointers like what I got to know how hot it is. You can tell when the oil's hot enough, but when it's shimmering in the pan, it's around 350. So there's some other reasons for preheating a pan. You could also blast the exterior of a steak to accelerate the mallard reactions, the browning mallard reactions. Mallard sound like a duck to me. blast it with a torch, like what y'all seen me do one time, and get it brown, and that'll stop it from sticking, and you can put it in the pan and it ain't gonna stick. So now you know. Even in a non-stick pan, meat can stick if it's not preheated. How about that? That's why you always see me put a Earl in my non-stick pan. It helps.
Okay, so here it is in here, and we gotta wrench off some of the pickling spices, and then pat it dry, patty cakes. And get some paper towels ready, and I'm gonna put them in the top of the pan, the lid of the pot that I'm gonna use to cook this in. Okay, I want to get these seeds off of that. I know you can't see. Be all right. I'm wrenching the seeds off the meat. There's many of them that'll come off without me getting a wire brush after their little ass. Okay. Now that meat say, "Ooh, look, it's all brown." That's because it done started cooking and reacting with that marinade. We're gonna pat it dry. It's been wrenched. But trust me, that stuff done soaked all up in that. Boy, it smells good too. Could you eat it raw like this? Steak tartare, however you say that? Sure, I guess you could. You got a tough stomach. Sure, that vinegar and kill everything. That may have been alive on it.
James, boy, James.
So, let me go preheat my pan so it just don't stick and brain. Now, while the oil's coming up to temp, we're going to go ahead and put some salt and pepper on this roast. Because it needs that. Didn't have any salt in that marinade except for the vinegar, whatever it had, all shimmering. See that? Guess y'all could have seen that. Now, turn the exhaust fan on, you know it's coming. I'm browning on most of the sides. Seasoning the other side. Let's see, did it stick? Nope. How about that? Smell like the Hofbrau house in here. The Earl's popping all over the place. It's too hot. Cut it back some. And no, Miss Debbie, I ain't used that cleaner yet because my stove ain't dirty enough. But this is going to dirty it up, trust me. I hadn't fried anything. Doing a commercial for the Fuller Brush Girl. Coming up. Now we got our roast brown. We're gonna go ahead and put some onions in here. Get them cooking. Also gotta get some carrots in here. Let them start cooking too. Look, I throwed that onion on the ground. Hey, that's a bitch. But these onions gonna release some water and start forming us a brown gravy in here. I think I was supposed to take that roast out. I don't know why. We just leave it go. Leave it get in there. Be like a slider. Wish we had a good German restaurant here in Baton Rouge, but we don't. The good one we had, the only one we had, really, the chef died. The owner died. And they've been out of business. It was delicious, too. I love German food. Did y'all know I was part German? I'm a mutt. Cajun, German. Got some Frenchy in me. Spanish. I don't remember what else. Did I say German?
Now let's pour our marinating liquids back in there. We're gonna strain all them seeds out later. Y'all come out of there. All of y'all come out of there, I said. I'm gonna get the rest out, don't you worry. I gotta get some carrots in there too. Let me go whack them up. We gotta add some more liquid to this. So I'm gonna do that. Chunk you some carrots in there. And all that gonna cook the pieces. They gotta go for a while. Now you can go drink pops and sing German folk songs. And hope them girls come by with the Oktoberfest shirts on. So what's them carrots do? It has sweetness, boy. Come on, naturally. Or you could use a sweet German wine, which I ain't got. I got some Cabernet Sauvignon Frenchie fried wine. Put some more of that in there. Remember the marinade started with a dry white wine also, but we added balsamic vinegar. So, smells like wine. Okay, now the recipe say to take the roast out and hope it don't fall to pieces. Because it looks like it's pretty damn tender. And strain this. I don't know why. But we're going to go ahead and strain the juices out. And I guess get the seeds away. And throw away everything else it says. Man, that's bullshit. I'm going to eat them carrots. And whatever onion pieces I can pick out of it. So let me do that. So we got a seedy. There you go. That's how you call them. And you see they got a lot of seeds in there. So, let's go on. Put that to the side. And we're going to return the roast to this. And thicken this gravy up. After I get another sip of pop. You want to thicken that gravy up. Did I say that already? Good. So I mixed up a little bit of cornstarch slurry. And we're going to pour that in there. And it's going to thicken up the gravy. Now, you know I got a sample of pizza. This is airborne. Yeah, I just fall apart. Oh, yum. Yum. Returning the roast to the gravy. Yum. So in the pot that we cooked the meat in, I've put some hot water in there, and this is going to be for the potato dumplings. Let's go on and put some Cajun seasonings in this water for them potato dumplings. You could just use salt and pepper. And I scavenged them carrots out of there, and they're good. I ain't letting them go to waste. So I got them right between them two pots. And this one back here in the back, I got the cornstarch in there, and it's gonna thicken the gravy up a little bit. And we're gonna have some potato dumplings. Am I gonna make them from scratch? Hell no. I got them in a box somewhere over there. Yeah, here they are. See, tater dumplings. Noodle. So my buddy over there in Germany sent me some of this. Three men paprika sauerkraut. Looking like got bell peppers and stuff in it. Three men's. Boy, I can't read German. Just nuke the damn thing, huh? I'll figure it out. Don't you worry about that.
So we got that dirty water. That's what the meat burled in. And we're gonna put them tater dumpling sacks in now. And burl in like the directions say.
Right, so I got the meat out and I'm gonna attempt to slice it thinly. But as you can see, it's just falling apart. Oh man, we're gonna have that with some gravy on it. Sauerbraten. I guess y'all can see down in there. Yum. What kind of meat was this? I don't remember now. To go watch the beginning of the video again. Sauerbraten. Yum. Don't bust it up, JB. See like that. Sampler. Sauerbraten gravy. Hey, these dumplings or cooked in a little sack. And what you gotta do is get the little sack off of them like that. Now let's get us some of this delicious gravy that we made and pour it all on top. See like that right there? You know them dumplings? Yum. See? Yum. 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 I gotta get some of that sauerkraut out of them. And we're gonna have this with some applesauce. Maybe a little sour cream. Who knows? Maybe on the seconds. This is first plate.